Joining us on Hot Copy this morning, we have former vice presidential candidate Walden Bello. Professor Bello, good morning to you, sir. Professor Bello, good morning. This is Karen. Yes. Can you hear me, sir?
Sorry. Yes, Karen, thanks a lot for inviting me to your program. I can now hear you loud and clear. Can you hear me?
I can hear you very well. What are your plans after your arrest yesterday, Professor Bello? What steps will you be taking?
Clearly this case is a top priority for us at this point. We will, in fact, have a press conference later this morning at around 10 o'clock at Max's at the Quezon Memorial area. And we will lay out our plans there. But very briefly, we feel that, you know, this charge is totally unjustified. It has no basis, in fact. And, you know, that we will come out on the winning side in the end, because you cannot suppress the truth. And, you know, the truth is on our side in this case, Karen.
Okay. When you say you cannot suppress the truth, let me read what you've said in your Facebook posts that actually caused this arrest. You actually said that Jeffrey Tupas was snorting 1.5 million worth of drugs during a beach party in Mabini, Davao de Oro, that was raided by authorities in November 2021. Did you have proof that Jeffrey Tupas was snorting drugs?
Well, that statement was among a series of political statements during the campaign that was put out by our social media team. And it was a statement made in the context of asking presidential candidate then, Sara Duterte, to explain a number of serious problems with her record as mayor of Davao. And this was in the context of our urging the vice president or the vice mayor to show up in a political debate in order for us to have an exchange, democratic exchange, as my record. So the mention of Mr. Tupas there was strictly incidental in the context with Mayor Sara Duterte at that point in time. And the Karen is that, in, as you all well know, instead of meeting us in a democratic debate and discussion, as the whole country was urging at that point to answer questions about her record, the camp of the mayor instead responded with a number of very intimidating actions, like this cyber libel suit, the City Council of Davao declaring me persona non grata, and Sara Duterte's camp labeling me a narco politician. So instead of meeting us in a good debate that was expected of candidates, we were in fact in the subjects of legal and political intimidation by the camp of Sara Duterte. I mean, let's face it, hindi naman tayo na pang, you know, we were not born yesterday. We know that the mayor running for vice president at that point was in fact the moving force behind this allegation of cyber libel. A person like Jeffrey Tupas would not have the courage to do this unless she was backed by big political force.
Okay.
And that is our point, that it is the vice president who then being mayor was the force behind the cyber libel charge.
Now, Professor, the vice president has repeatedly denied having anything to do with Jeffrey Tupas filing this case. But let me ask you this, because I do believe in the decriminalization of libel. I mean, being a media personality, I believe that. But I want to ask you personally, was it responsible for you in any way to also accuse someone of being a drug user if you did not have proof that Jeffrey Tupas was snorting 1.5 million pesos worth of drugs, regardless of how you meant it and what the context was? In effect, that sentence in your Facebook post accuses someone of using drugs. You don't believe that you went overboard with freedom of expression here and freedom of speech?
No, no. That was, Karen, that was in the context of a political campaign in which what we were raising were questions about the mayor's ability to be able to administer Davao in an appropriate way as mayor. You see, the problem here is that the fact that Ms. Tupas had been arrested, I mean, had been seen in a drug bust in a party in which drugs were flowing, in which my social media team made statements that she was there, and that she was let free.
I believe Jeffrey
by the Padilla agent, by the Padilla force, after she identified herself as the press information officer of Sara Duterte. And right after that, by the way, Karen, the mayor dismissed Ms. Tupas from her role. So there is, you know, there is this very strong connection between these different events.
Yeah, well, one is I've spoken to Jeffrey Tupas in the past. I believe he's a he. So let's correct this. Am I correct, Professor?
She's a she.
Let's leave it at this. Now, what I wanted to ask you is, do you want to apologize? Because clearly you believe that you weren't being literal. You weren't being literal in your expression, but then by accusing someone of snorting drugs, it could be seen as a basis for defamation and destroying someone's character. Do you want to apologize or explain that it was you did not mean it in a literal sense?
I cannot apologize to a camp, you know, that is bringing this suit of cyber libel against me, infringing on my right to freedom of speech. And as I gave you the context, Karen, the context was in the course of a political campaign and a challenge to Sara Duterte to answer allegations about her capability as mayor, including the fact that we raised that was she aware that Ms. Tupas, her PIO, had been discovered by Padilla agents to be at a drug party where the drugs were flowing, but that she was released because she said she was with Sara Duterte's office. And the day after, or 2 days after, Sara dismissed her from office. So let's put this in the context of the events as they were happening. Yeah.
But then
in
dismissing
the context of a challenge to debate.
Yeah, but dismissing. I wanted to ask you, yes, dismissing Tupas for being in that situation is different from your statement in Facebook alleging that Tupas was snorting drugs. That's why there's a technicality here. So you did accuse them of weaponizing the law. I won't argue with that. But then that very statement of accusing someone to have snorted drugs, whether you meant it in another context, whether it was figurative in nature, that statement, Professor Bellio, is the issue.
The issue, Karen, is that that statement by my social media team was made in the context of a challenge to the vice president, then mayor, to answer these allegations in the context of a political debate, in asking her to please show up so that we can debate issues. Like, was she aware that her PIO was at this party where drugs were flowing? So that is the context in which that statement was made.
But that wasn't the statement. See, the statement wasn't, was she aware that Tupas was in a party where drugs were flowing? I know I'm being technical here, but this is what's used against you in this case, is the statement that Tupas was snorting drugs.
Yes, but I guess what I'm saying is that the statement that was made by social media team was in the context of questions being directed at Sara Duterte's capability as a manager, and that dimension of Mr. Tupas was just an example of what we regarded as her capability of managing the affairs of Davao. That is the whole context of that statement. So if one takes a few words and takes it out of context, you know, that is what is being done here, and is made the whole basis of an effort to intimidate me and subvert my freedom of speech. Karen, remember that this was one of several responses, not to debate me, but which included, at that point in time, labeling me a narco-politician and declaring me, the City Council of Davao, declaring me persona non grata. So instead of responding during a political campaign, these are issues raised in a political campaign. Instead, what the camp of Sara Duterte did was to weaponize the law and not respond according to the rules of debate, but to intimidate us through invocation and use of the law.
All right. One more question when it comes to your team. Does this mean you did not actually write that Facebook post? Is that fair to say? You entrusted your social media team to write the post for you? Because it's quite known that candidates have a social media team that handles their social media. You did not write that actual post.
Well, as you said, Karen, I had a whole battery of social media people.
So you did not write that, you personally. You did not write that particular statement, which is what's accused, the case that's been filed against you. You did not write it?
At this point in time, I do not remember the actual circumstances of the writing of that. Because as we all know, Karen, we have teams. You know, you've been in a political campaign. You know that we have blanket authorization to our people because we do feel that they are responsible people and thinking people. And that's where this statement came from at this point. I do not recall the actual circumstances of the writing of that post.
Okay, now let's talk about the bigger issue. The ASEAN parliamentarians group has called this political harassment. Many media organizations in the past have already called for the decriminalization of libel in the Philippines. No less than some members of Congress have refiled the bill decriminalizing libel. We are one of the countries left in the world, I believe, where libel is still a crime. What hope are you seeing for this bill, considering this was used against you today?
Well, I do have my hopes in our legislative process in the Senate as well as in the House that they will eventually decriminalize, libel and cyber libel. Mm-mm. And I think it is a good thing that this case is now before the public, because by showing its application to me, without any legal basis in fact, but wholly being politically motivated, the example of the vice president, then mayor, using it so blatantly for political purposes will be an example to people of, my God, you know, we have this monster of a law that can be used by opportunistic politicians like Sara Duterte and other opportunistic politicians who don't want to debate the issues, but instead just want to weaponize the law in order to suppress dissent. So my sense, Karen, is good that we are now debating my case here, that it has surfaced, and that we will be able to have a legal process in which we will show, my team will show, you know, that not only am I innocent of the charges, but this is a bad law that should never have been passed in the first place, because it is anti-democratic and can be used by petty tyrants like the vice president in order to advance their political careers.
Okay, now we know this in history. I mean, we've had leaders that are quite sensitive with the use of words. I mean, let's go to the late Cory Aquino, where she filed a libel case against the late Louis Beltran when he claimed that she hid under the bed during one of the coups. Do you remember this, Professor Bellio?
Yes, yes.
And she was very upset and angry, because she felt then, even if it was figurative, as Louis Beltran then claimed, he was one of my mentors, is the late Cory Aquino said, no, it makes me come out as a weak leader, and literally people will think I hid under the bed. So this was a discussion in many of the journalism sessions we've had. And of course, at some point, that was junked. And today, we have one third of cyber libel cases junked as well that have been filed since 2012. But the key really is just how far can freedom of expression go? Because what you're telling us right now is it's not literal. It's in context of, correct, Professor? Right?
Yes.
You're not calling Tupas a drug addict, is what you're saying. Or a drug user.
What I'm saying is that the whole statement that was made by my social media team should be taken in the context of a statement being directed at Sara Duterte and not specifically at Tupas.
Yeah. So this is not unique. This is not new.
Sure.
We've seen leaders go through this. Your experience is not new. But do you believe that, I mean, just to balance our conversation, because coming from the media, we do know the leverage and the breadth of how far journalists can go worldwide. Do you believe it also, the law is also limiting what we can use in terms of either play of words, context, the liberties that journalists use, or even the liberties that social media users can use?
Definitely, that law has a chilling effect on all forms of expressions of free speech. Let me just use what you just said, Karen. I think President Cory Aquino was definitely wrong in using cyber libel to go, to go after Mr. Beltran's statement.
Yeah, it was libel before. Wala pang cyber libel, but go ahead. Yeah. Yes.
Yeah, that she hid under the bed. A statement that should have been done in the context of the give and take of response to allegations in a free social debate. Mm. And let the people judge from that. Instead, what happened in the case of both, the camp of Sara Duterte and President Aquino was, in fact, to use the law in order, to stifle dissent. Instead of letting this come out in a free exchange of ideas. And that's what democracy is all about. You use free exchange, whether, whatever the ways it is expressed in a literary, poetic, and other fashion, let that be the level at which things get discussed. At this point in time, you will have, so many at any given day in the Philippines, so many expressions by journalists like yourself. If you have opportunistic politicians, they can pick it out, and label you as having committed cyber libel or libel.
Let's just close this in context already. So you have a precedent with... that's a pretty big one, the case of the late President Cory Aquino to Luis Beltran. But to close, please, sir, what would you like to say?
What I would like to say is that that this case, this cyber libel charge against me, I think I am innocent of the charge, that this shows that, in fact, a really bad law like cyber libel can be used to stifle legitimate free expression in this country. Mm-hmm. I feel that it's a good thing that my case is now in the public view, and that it will take the legal process, because what we intend to show is not only my innocence, but the fact that this law is a great danger to democracy. Therefore, libel must be decriminalized. Mm. We cannot afford to have laws that abridge freedom of expression. A speech in this country that can be used by opportunistic politicians like the vice president. Thank you.
All right. On that note, Professor Walden Bellio, thank you so much for joining me this morning. You take care, sir.
Thank you.